Hello friends and welcome to Virtual Study Hub. Today I am going to tell you about the history of Taj Mahal and about its main characters Shah Jahan and Mumtaz Mahal, its architecture and many things more. So don't blink or you will miss them. Let's get to know about the basic information of Taj Mahal. The Taj Mahal is an ivory white marble mausoleum on the southern bank of River Yamuna in the Indian city of Agra. It was commissioned in 1632 by Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan for the tomb of his favorite wife Mumtaz Mahal. After his death, he was buried in this place only. The tomb is a centerpiece of 42-acre complex which includes a mosque and a guest house and is a set of informal gardens bounded by three sides of centrated wall. Construction of the mausoleum was essentially completed in 1643, but work continued on other phases for the project for another 10 years. The Taj Mahal complex is believed to have been completed in its entirety 1653 at a cost of estimated 32 million rupees, which in 2020 would be approximately 70 billion rupees. So it's very expensive. The construction project employed some 20,000 artisans under the guidance of a board architects led by the court architect to the Emperor Ustad Ahmed Lahori. The Taj Mahal was destined as an UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1983 for being the jewel of Muslim art in India and one of the universally admired pieces of the world's heritage. It is regarded by many as the best example of Mughal architect and a symbol of India's rich history. The Taj Mahal architecture attracts 7 to 8 million visitors a year, and in 2007 it was declared the winner of the new 7 Wonders of the World 2000 to 2007 Initiative League. After the construction was complete, the builders cut their hands so that they cannot remake another building comparable to the Taj Mahal. Now, let's get to know the person who commissioned it. Shah Jahan, the 5th Mughal Emperor, who reigned from 1628 to 1658, was widely considered one of the greatest Mughal emperors, as under his reign, the Mughal Empire reached its peak of glory. Although an able military commander, he is perhaps best remembered for his architectural achievements. His reign unleashed in the golden age of Mughal architecture. Shah Jahan commissioned many monuments, and the best known is Taj Mahal in Agra, which entombs his favorite wife Mumtaz Mahal and he himself. His relationship with Mumtaz Mahal has been heavily adopted into Indian art, literature and cinema. Shah Jahan was the most contempt of Emperor Jahangir's four sons. Jahangir's death in late 1627 spurred a war of succession from which Shah Jahan emerged victorious after much intrigue. He put to death all of his rivals for the throne and crowned himself as emperor in January 1628 in Agra under his regnal title Shah Jahan. His rule saw many grand building projects including the Red Fort and the Shah Jahan Mosque. Foreign affairs saw war with the Safavids and conflict with the Portuguese, but positions relation with the Ottoman Empire, domestic concerns including putting down numerous rebellions and a devastating famine from 1630 to 1632. When his favorite wife Mumtaz Mahal died in childbirth during the birth of the 14th child, he commissioned a spectacular tomb for her in the great mausoleum of Taj Mahal. In September 1657, Shah Jahan fell seriously ill. This set a war of succession among his four sons, in which his third son, Aurangzeb, emerged victorious and oppressed his father. Shah Jahan recovered from his illness, but Aurangzeb put his father under house arrest in Agra Fort from July 1658 until his death on January 1666. He was laid to rest next to his wife in Taj Mahal. Now let's get to know the person for whom this spectacular tomb was made. Mumtaz Mahal. Mumtaz Mahal was born as
Arjunman Banu Begum in Agra to be a family of Persian nobility. She was the daughter of Abul Hasan Asaf Khan, a wealthy Persian noble who held high office in the Mughal Empire, and the niece of Empress Nur Jahan, the chief wife of Emperor Jahangir and the power behind the emperor. She married at the age of 19 on 30 April 1612 to Prince Khurram, later known by his regal name Shah Jahan, who conferred upon the title to her Mumtaz Mahal. Although betrothed to Shah Jahan since 1607, she ultimately became his second wife in 1612. Mumtaz and her husband had 14 children, including Jahan, the Begum, Shah Jahan's favorite daughter, and Crown Prince Dara Shikoh, the heir apparent anointed by his father, who temporarily succeeded him until deposed by Mumtaz Mahal's sixth child, Aurangzeb, who ultimately succeeded his father as the sixth Mughal emperor in 1658. Mumtaz Mahal died in 1631 Burhanpur in Deccan, present near Madhya Pradesh, during the birth of their 14th child, a daughter named Guhar Vara Begum. Shah Jahan had Taj Mahal built as a tomb for her, which is considered to be a monument of undying love. As with other Mughal royal ladies, we have no contemporary likeness that are accepted as for her, but numerous imagined portraits were created from the 19th century onwards. This portrait is actually a piece of art done on a ceramic plate. Let us get to know about a bit of its architecture. As we know, it is made out of marble and many more special materials. The Taj Mahal is renowned for its Mughal architecture, although its style combines with elements from Persia, Ottoman, Turkish and Indian architecture. It was inspired by certain Timurid and Mughal buildings such as the Gur-e-Amir. Ustad Ahmed Lahori was the main architect of Taj Mahal. As we heard before, the artisans would cut off their hand after the completing of this spectacular tomb so that they cannot remake another building that will be comparable to this spectacular mausoleum. Why does the Taj Mahal shine in full moon night? It's said that if you can visit the Taj Mahal in a full moon night, you are very lucky. The Taj Mahal is a unique sight of kind under the moonlight, and there is no better time than seeing it at full moon night. As the moonlight reflects on the white monument, the marble shines and offers a resplendent beauty of vastness, giving it a beautiful blue hue. So that's the reason for what it shines under the spectacular moonlight. Effect of pollution. The pollution has a great impact on our spectacular tomb. Here in the picture you can see how the beautiful white color is turning into yellowish brown. It is the acid rain that is most dangerous for this monument. Indeed, the inverted emission of sulfuric oxide due to road traffic causes acid rain. This rain colors the Taj Mahal yellowish, tarnishing it, and worse, it erodes it, attacking what is most fragile at first, the sculptures and the incisions of the stone. An immense mausoleum of white marble built in Agra between 1631 to 1648 by daughter of Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan is a jewel of Muslim art in India and one of the universally admired masterpieces of world heritage. So it is our duty, the duty of Indians, to protect this universally admired art. That is a pride for many Indians, and many respect Indians just for this. So it is a pridal thing in India, and it is our duty to protect it. So friends, that's all for today. If you enjoyed the video, please like, comment, share with your friends, and if you are new to our channel, don't forget to subscribe. And yeah, there are many more videos, so don't forget to check them out. And yeah, thank you for watching.